Hello everyone, my name is Deepika Vansal and here I am discussing about the mobile computing. In the fourth unit we have mobile IP concepts. So we will discuss introduction of mobile IP. Let's see. This is the vision and mission of the Information Technology Department of GCRC College. Now we will see the what is mobile IP or how it works. So here is the introduction. In IP networks, routing is based on stationary IPs. Similarly to how a postal letter is delivered to the fixed address on the envelope, a device on a network is reachable through normal IP routing by the IP address it is assigned on the network. What it means, as we buy a SIM or a mobile, so we are allotted with a unique number of mobile number or with a single number of that particular SIM. If we are using in the home address, like we are buying in the Kota city, so it is the home address for that particular mobile or the particular SIM. As we move in the different city like Jaipur or some other place, that will be the foreign address for that particular mobile SIM. So mobile IP works in this scenario as, but the mobile IP address will remain same in your mobility. So here is the mobile IP. Mobile IP signifies that while a user is connected to an application across the internet and the user's point of attachment changes dynamically, all connections are maintained despite the change in underlying network properties. So here it means when we are changing the location, so we connect disconnect the network dynamically because of the handoff or the mobility of your cell phone or the mobile. So we are connected with a particular internet, but we don't change the mobile IP. We are dynamical in the point of contact or point of internet. Similar to the handoff roaming situation in the cellular network, mobile IP allows the mobile node to use the two IP addresses called the home address and the care of address. As we discussed previously, the particular address of mobile or the SIM where you purchased it, that will be the home address, and the care of address when you move in the mobility, when you move or change the location, that will be your new address, that will be as called the care of address. The home address is static, as we have the permanent address static and the everybody knows it. The care of address changes as we change the rented house or we change the location as we are going. Now these four terminologies we will frequently use in this PPT: mobile node, home agent, foreign agent and care of address. Mobile node, system that can change the point of connection to the network without changing its IP address. Okay, as we discussed it, your mobile can be said as a mobile node, and home agent work in the home network between the server or the mobile node. As the foreign agent, route in the current visitor network of the mobile node, which forwards the tunnel datagram to the mobile node, also act as the default router for the registered mobile network. As the care of address, we discuss as you have renting a house or having some other location other than your home address, that will be considered as a care of address. So we can see by the diagram where is the home agent and the foreign agent relays. In the first diagram, we can see internet connected with the mobile host and the second mobile host. So if we are discussing the first IP, as we can see in the left side, home network has a particular IP of original home address or the mobile host address that will with the another network, then we will call it the foreign network. And the IP will be changed with the care of address. We can see in the diagram. As the second diagram has the mobile network. In the second diagram, we can see internet and the mobile network has a middle point or the switch that will be called as a home agent, and the internet and the foreign network has the middle point as a foreign agent. We can see home agent and the foreign agent where it works. As a mobile IP, normal working, we will discuss in these slides. So by the diagram, we will understand this. Firstly, if server request for a particular data or something to the your mobile node, then server will request to the home agent. Home agent searches the mobile node. If it in the network, then it is okay. Otherwise, if it is in foreign network, then request will be sent to the foreign agent in the second step. In the third step, foreign agent will be by the foreign network inform the mobile node about that request. Mobile node will process that request and reply to directly server, because mobile node knows the server's address, but server doesn't know the mobile node's actual care of address or the actual address that relies on the mobile node. So in the fourth step, mobile node will directly reply to the foreign agent, and foreign agent will be revert to the server. So here's the working of mobile IP in the theoretical points which we have discussed in this diagram. So IP consists of three main steps and hold the process. There are the three steps. First is the agent discovery, second is the registration process, and third is the tunneling, or we can say data transfer. So we will discuss these three points. Discovery. A mobile node uses a discovery process to identify prospective home agent and the foreign agent. Second is the registration. A mobile node uses a registration process to inform its home agent its care of address. If it is rely on something foreign agent or the foreign network, then it will let to know care of address. Tunneling. Tunneling process is used to forward IP datagrams from a home address to a care of address. So by this particular diagram, we will discuss whole process. The first is the discovery, second is the registration, and third is the tunneling. So we will see the first is the agent discovery, phase one. We can see in the diagram, we have mobile node and the home agent. When it moves to the foreign agent, then it will be called the mobile host after move in the foreign agent, and the remote host in the right hand side. So first phase is the agent discovery. Firstly, mobile node will agent solicitation. Solicitation means it will identify by the home agent that that particular mobile node is by the affiliated by the Jio or the Vodafone or the BSNL or the Idea. Solicitation means the agent providers, the providers of the network. So by the agent solicitation, we will forward to the request to the home agent, and home agent will be advertise your mobile node. If mobile node is rely on the foreign network, then firstly agent solicitation by the foreign agent, and agent advertisement by the foreign agent. Then second phase is the registration. You have to register your particular mobile node in which network you are moving or relying on it. So mobile node, if it is in the home agent, then it will be request firstly home agent for the registration and reply by the registration confirmation. But if it is in the foreign network, as we can see in the diagram in the second phase, registration request will be forwarded to the foreign agent request forwarded to the mobile agent. Mobile agent will be confirmed your registration, and then foreign agent will be forwarded to you. Then after that, this connection, you can transfer the data, or you can do the tunneling, whatever you want to communicate in between those two mobile hosts, we can done that. These are the description of these three steps. So first was the discovery. So we can see extension of ICMP routing advertisement. Home agent and the foreign agent broadcast agent advertisement at the regular interval. The mobile IP uses control messages that are sent to and from UDP port 334. UDP port 334 work as if you are advertising or sending the advertisement at a regular interval by the network congestion or any problem, if that will be missed or If that will be missed or distorted, then it can't be recent. UDP port 334 works on the discarding the data that is missing or having something trouble with the network. So agent advertisement works allow for the detection of mobility agents, list one or more available care of addresses, informs the mobile node about special features, mobile node selects its care of address, mobile node checks whether the agent is a home agent or the foreign agent. These are in the discovery process. The registration process is used by a mobile node to inform the foreign agent that it is visiting. The new care of address of the mobile node is sent to the home agent by the registration process. Registration expires, duration is negotiated during registration. Mobile must reach the register before it expires. As we are doing the advertisement in a regular interval, as we have registration with the same point of view, we will re-register the mobile node in the foreign agent in a regular interval before it expires its duration. All registrations are authenticated. So we can see by the diagram in a short form how registration works. If foreign agent advertises about the agent, then mobile node requests for the registration process for the foreign agent, then foreign agent will be forward that mobile node request to its home agent. Home agent reply by the registration confirmation and foreign agent will be sent to the mobile node. Tunneling. As we discussed, the third step and the last step for which we are doing the discovery and the registration, that is tunneling. Tunneling has the encapsulation routing, or the tunneling consists of the delivery of packet to the mobile node at its current care of address. So we can see in the bottom diagram, as we are sending some particular data to between the nodes, so original data is encapsulated by the original IP header. That is known as home address. Original IP header is a home address. Then we will see that particular mobile node is not on the home agent. It is relay on the foreign agent or the foreign network. So that data will be encapsulated by the new IP header, and that header is a foreign agent address, new IP header. Then if it change to new network, then we will add that IP also. So we can see the encapsulated data in the form of new data. New data has the original data and the inner header, that is the home address, and the outer header is a care of address or your foreign address or foreign agent address. So we can see the tunneling or the packeting or encapsulating of the data in this. So sender does not need to know the mobile node